Hello students, today class number 16 and exercise number 1b. Now this is the third row, first problem. If a point P is moving such that the length of tangents drawn from P to the circuits x square plus y square minus 4x minus 6y minus 12 is equal to 0, and another circle x square plus y square plus 6x plus 18y plus 26 is equal to 0, or in the ratio 2:3, then find the equation of locus of P. Now here students, the locus condition is the locus point is moving in a plane such that the ratio of the distances from this point to this two circles which are in the ratio 2:3, that means the length of the tangent drawn from the point P to the both circles are in the ratio 2:3. Here this is the one of the rough diagram. Here two circles are there. One circle we construct S is equal to 0, and another circle here we construct S dash is equal to 0, and this is the locus point x1 comma y1. Now this, the length of the tangent drawn from the point P to the circle S, that is PA, and this is the length of the tangent drawn from the point P to the another circle, that is equal to PB. Here PA and PB both are the length of the tangents drawn from the x1 point to the both circles, but the ratio of these distances is equal, the length of this ratio is equals to 2:3. Now so after that, to simplify this locus condition, then we'll getting the locus equation of P. So now here taking this, the locus point, here the locus point coordinates, here we construct P is equal to x1 comma y1. Here the given circles we construct S, here S is equals to, so one of the circle x square plus y square minus 4x minus 6y minus 12 is equal to 0, and another circle S dash, the second one, here x square plus y square plus 6x plus 18y plus 26. Here these are the two circles here. Now the locus condition is the ratio of the length of the tangents, that means here the PA is to PB, PA is to PB is equal to 2:3, then PA by PB is equals to 2/3, but PA is equal to length of the tangent is given by root S11, and PB, length of the tangent drawn from P to the another circle, is given by S dash 11. Here PA is equal to root S11 by here root S dash 11 is equal to 2/3. Here students, so squaring on both sides and cross multiplication. Here for the square roots both are cancelled, that means here S11 by S dash 11, and 2/3 its square is 4/9, then cross multiplication, this becomes 9 of S11 is equal to 4 of S dash 11. Here now to apply the value of S11 and S dash 11. Here this is the S, x square plus y square minus 4x minus 6y minus 12, and its S11 is given by x1 square plus y1 square minus 4x1 minus 6y1 minus 12. Here this is the S dash, and its S dash 11 is given by x1 square plus y1 square plus 6x1 plus 18y1 plus 26. Here now substituting all these values here, 9 of S11 here x1 square plus y1 square minus 4x1 minus 6y1 minus 12, and here 4 of S dash 11 is x1 square plus y1 square plus 6x1 plus 18y1 plus 26. Now its simplification here, 9x1 square, yes, 9x1 square plus 9y1 square, 9 4 36 x1, here 9 54 y1, 9 6 54, minus 9 12 108, and all these terms multiply with 4, yes, 4x1 square plus 4y1 square, here 24x1 plus, and here 72y1, 18 4 ja 72y1 plus and 26 are 4 jar. Here 104. 104. Okay. Now all these terms we kept into the LHS side. 9x1 square minus 4x1 square, 5x1 square. And 9y1 square minus 4y1 square, 5y1 square. And students, minus 36x1. Here also, plus 24x1, we will write in LHS side, changes as a minus. Minus 36 and minus 24 here. So minus 60x1. Minus 60x1. Here minus 54y1 is there, and here plus 72 we write in LHS side, this becomes as a minus. Minus 54 minus 72, yes, minus here how much? So 72 and 54, yes, 126 here, 126y1. And minus 108, yes, so plus 104, so minus, both are minus, so minus 212. Yes, friends, finally, the locus equation of P is given by 5x square plus 5y square minus 60x minus 126y minus 212 is equal to 0. 212 is equal to 0. Yes, so 5x square plus 5y square minus 60x minus 126y minus 212 is equal to 0. Yeah, this is the required locus equation of P. So for the given condition is the ratio of its the length of the tangents drawn from the point P to the both circles which are in the ratio 2:3, and after that then we'll get in the suitable locus equation of P is 5x square plus 5y square minus 60x minus 126y minus 212 is equal to 0. Okay, students, so this is the second problem. So if a point P is moving such that the length of tangents drawn from the point P to the both circles x square plus y square plus 8x plus 12y plus 15 is equal to 0, and x square plus y square minus 4x minus 6y minus 12 is equal to 0 or equal, then find the equation of locus of P. It is the same model. Here now, here the length of the tangents drawn from the x1 point to the both circuits are equal. That means here this is the rough diagram, one of the rough diagram here. These are the both circuits, s is equal to 0 and s dash is equal to 0. Now taking the locus point as P of x1 comma y1, and the length of the tangent run from the point P to the first circle is PA, and the another circle is a PB. Here PA, PB both are the length of the tangents, but both lengths are equal. So this is the locus condition here. The mathematical condition is both lengths are equal. Then we have to find out the locus equation of P. Now for this, so taking the locus point, the locus point coordinates we should take as x1 comma y1, and the given circles. Yes, the given circles. Here, yes, we consider the first circle as s. S is equals to x square plus y square plus 8x plus 12y plus 15 is equal to 0. And another one is s dash. S dash is equal to x square plus y square minus 4x minus 6y minus 12 is equal to 0. So students, these are the given two circles. Now, so we are taking the locus point as x1 comma y1. The locus condition here, the given condition here, the given condition. The given condition means both lengths are equal. That means here PA is equals to PB. But PA here root S11 and PB root S dash 11, sparing on both sides. That means we are getting this S1 is equal to S dash 11. S11 of the given circle, yes. This can be written as X1 square plus Y1 square plus 8X1 plus 12 y1 plus 15 is 15, and s dash 11 is x1 square plus y1 square minus 4x1 minus 6y1 minus 12. Here putting all these values of s11 and s11 in this relation, then on both sides here x1 square and y1 square both are cancelled. Now this 8x1 is there, 12y1 plus in LHS side 8x1 plus 12y1 plus 15, in another side RHS side minus 4x1 minus 6y1 minus, all these RHS side terms we kept into the LHS side, 8x1 plus 12y1 plus 15 here plus 4x1 plus 6y1 plus 12 is equal to 0, and its implication 8x1 plus 4x1 here 12x1 12y1 plus 6y1 18y1 and 15 plus 12 is equal to 27 plus 27 is equal to 0. Here in this 3 common, here totally 3 common, here 4x1 plus so 6y1 plus 9. So here finally the locus equation is, here the locus equation is 4x plus 6y, 6y plus 9 is equal to 0. Here it is our required locus equation of P such that both lengths are equal. That means here it's represent a straight line. Okay, so this is the second problem based on the length of the tangents. Here the both lengths are equal. After simplification, then we will get the required locus equation 4x plus 6y plus 9 is equals to 0.